Good morning, good afternoon. Good afternoon, folks. Excited to be here with you today, and I'm just going to run through a number of different slides that will tell you some information. But the big point that I was thinking about on the way over here is it's been a number of years since I've been in Baltimore. And I was trying to figure out what do I have in common with you. And one thing I have in common with you, or at least a number of you in the room, I would think, is our mutual love for the movie Diner. And in the movie Diner, the character played by Kevin Bacon and the character played by Mickey Rourke are watching a loving woman in a freshman outfit jump. Of course, it's a very aristocratic scene in Maryland, and they're Baltimore guys. And the Kevin Bacon character turns to Mickey Rourke and he says, "Do you ever get the feeling there's something going on we don't know about?" So my wish for you, and I think all of our wish, is that your stakeholders never say that about your foundation. And also may your stakeholders never see your foundation as an inaccessible, aristocratic equestrian horse jumper. Unfortunately, that is how some foundations are seen right now. We'll get into that. We hear a lot in recent philanthropy conferences about the moments that we face as a country and as a sector. We hear about the education moment. We hear about the economy moment. We hear about the healthcare moment. We hear about the environmental moment. How can we, as foundations, meet the moment? And one of the answers that we submit is by going outside. Now, the definition of going outside to make connections through various means with community, government, business, news media, and nonprofit leaders who operate beyond the closed orbit of foundations. And here's the sticking point, i.e. not your grantees, not your grant seekers, and not your donors. So that's what we mean by going outside. We're going to talk about how we might do that. ABAC survey your view before this meeting, and one of the questions we asked, or you asked, was how important to your success is communicating with broader audiences, such as community, government, business, and community leaders. And it's that 58%, not important or only occasionally important, that we want to move to the red, communicate regularly and mission critical. And that's my mission. If I've moved a few of you down that way, I'll have been successful. So let's talk a little bit about the who of going outside. And the first thing we notice among foundations that do this well is that a shift. So going outside means broadening your audience beyond the usual suspects. But then once you get outside, it means narrowing. And it means narrowing from the typical general public audience, where we want to reach all of our community members, to narrowing in on influentials. And what we mean by influentials is the two inner circles. The inner circle of the 12% of engaged Americans, and this is what Harrison Rock estimates to be 12% of U.S. adults, who have been active leaders on their boards or committees or staff leaders of organizations doing important work on social or community issues. So these are your grantees, your grantee board members, they're your board members, they're you. They're active, engaged citizens in their communities, and then we much more roughly estimate that a half of 1% of U.S. adults, decision makers in government, business, news media, and the nonprofit community. And these are what we mean by influentials. So the question that I want you to think about for just a moment, right now, is think of one person who matches this going outside definition. This going outside definition, one person who you need to reach in the next 6 months to get your work done. And the key is, they can't be a grantee, they can't be a grant seeker, they can't be a donor, and you don't know them. So think of one person, and write it down, who you need to reach over the next 6 months to get your work done, to have an impact.